in Act 2, Section 1 of A Doll's House, it's Christmas Day, and Nora has refused to see her children. Nora talks with the nurse, a woman who essentially has raised Nora, acting as her mother, and they talk about the costume and the children. The nurse says the costume needs mending. It can easily be put in order with patience. Nora says she would like to tear the dress into 100,000 pieces. She's actually said this of the bond for the debt, the nasty, dirty paper, to Christine earlier. Then, Nora asks the nurse how she could have left her own daughter behind to work full-time as Nora's nurse. The nurse replies, "A poor girl who has got into trouble should be glad to. Besides, that wicked man didn't do a single thing for me." Nora nervously prepares for the upcoming costume party with Christine, who drops by to help mend Nora's old, torn costume, which Torvald insists Nora wear. They discuss Dr. Rank and her loan problem. Christine finds Nora's relationship with Dr. Rank really strange. She leaves when Torvald enters. Nora begs him not to fire Krogstad. Angered, Torvald sends the dismissal letter to Krogstad immediately, instead of waiting until the new year. Softening a little, Torvald makes a promise to Nora he will later break. "Come what will, I shall have both courage and strength if they be needed." Right after Torvald makes this declaration, he soothes Nora, saying, "There, there, not those frightened dove's eyes." The state of the Christmas tree in the beginning of this section serves to show the passing of time and represents Nora's emotional decline. The candles on the tree are burned down, the tree is in the corner stripped of its ornaments, and its branches are disheveled. This section continues to weave connections between the characters, specifically between Nora and Dr. Rank, and between Torvald and Nora's papa. Dr. Rank is an example of immorality manifesting from one generation into the next. Nora tells Christine his father was a horrible man, and that is why his son was sickly from childhood. Near the end of the scene, Torvald assumes Nora is in a frightened state because she's traumatized by humiliation from childhood when her father was suspected of immoral behavior. Torvald claims an important difference between himself and her papa. "Your father's reputation as a public official was not above suspicion." Here, husband and wife are shown as intrinsically linked, as are father and daughter. The interwoven relationships and their resonant traumas and shames invite the audience to question whether it is truly possible for an individual to even exist outside of society. Torvald calling Nora a dove rather than the usual skylark or songbird invokes a dove's symbolic religious significance. Thus, a connection between marriage and religion is suggested here.